Give me strength when I'm weary.
Pentland Parish was formed in January 2018 and comprises the four former parishes of Cannesby, Dunnet, Keese and Ulrigg, all now under one single charge, retaining four places of worship. The mission statement of Pentland Parish is to be valued in our communities as vibrant, caring and growing fellowships, enabling each other to spread the good news of Jesus Christ for the furtherance of God's kingdom. This video is a record of the parish, its buildings inside and out, and of the parish countryside as at late 2020.
Welcome to Keese Church, which serves the village of Keese and the surrounding area. Keese itself has a population of around 650. There's an excellent primary school and a community hall. The church itself is a parliamentarian church, and it was built in 1827. This is the sanctuary, and there is a small hall and kitchen attached to the side of the church.
Of Duncansby are some of the most impressive in the British Isles. The great stack is over 60 metres high and rises above the summit of the adjacent cliff. Duncansby Head is the most northeasterly part of the British mainland, slightly northeast of John O'Groats. The headland juts into the North Sea with the Pentland Firth and its treacherous tides separating mainland Caithness with the Orkney Islands.
Those who trust in your word, oh my Lord, they will soar, they will glide like an eagle in the sky. They will walk, not be weary till the work is done. Oh, Jesus, be my vision.
To Cannesby Church. This building, it was built 1720 to 1724. So actually this year we should have been having a celebration for its 300th anniversary, but unfortunately that hasn't happened. We have a fairly small congregation here, but very enthusiastic and very dedicated. We use the church building during the summer months and go over to the church hall for Sunday worship during the colder winter months. This has been a site of worship since the 6th century when St. Drostan came from Wales to preach to the Picts. The original church was pre-Reformation, so before 1560. The first Presbyterian minister was Andrew Ogston, and seemingly he enjoyed the bagpipes. And rather than ring the church bell to call people to worship, he had pipers going round the parish calling the people to worship. We have communion silver, which was donated to the church by Sir Oliver Mowat, the third Premier of Ontario. His parents belonged to the village of May. Another feature in this church is John O'Groats' tombstone. It's the oldest tombstone we have, dated 1568. The island of Stroma is part of this parish, and up until 1887, when they built their own church, the people of Stroma used to come across to Canasby in their little rowing boats and worship here. The story goes that if the weather was suitable and they didn't come, they could be fined threepence for not attending the church, but I don't know how much truth is in that. One of our most famous parishioners, of course, was the late Queen Mother, who worshipped in this church every August for almost 50 years. And there is a plaque to her memory donated by Prince Charles, the Duke of Rothesay. When the Queen Mother first came here, she was advised that there was a door at the back which the Earls of Caithness had used, and she could use it to come in privately if she wished. However, she said, no, lock the door, I'll come in at the front door with everybody else, which she did, and we were always delighted to see her. Fortunately, her grandson, Prince Charles, now follows the tradition and worships here when he's at the Castle of Meath. One of our most famous ministers was John Morrison, Dr. John Morrison, who co-wrote some of the paraphrases, and probably best known the lines, "His voice commands the tempest forth and stills the stormy wave." It's believed he wrote that while looking out at the Pentland Firth from the manse windows.
Welcome to Dunnet Church. History tells us that there has been a church on this site since 700 to 800 AD, but that most of that old church is now under our feet. Dunnet Church is part of the most northerly parish on the mainland, and the most northerly bit is Dunnet Head. Not John O'Groats, as everybody might think, which most folk go to. As you can see, we have a lovely old church here, quite a small congregation, but very well supported by the community. We have a messy church for the younger ones, which is well supported and run by some very able folk. As we're on the North Coast 500 route, we're able to show off our lovely church and the beautiful scenery to everyone. Unfortunately, this year, due to COVID, that's not been available, but we're hopeful that in the future we'll be able to do so again.
Dunnet Head, not John O'Groats, is the most northerly point on the UK mainland at 58 degrees latitude. Nearby, Bourifa Hill was an experimental radio station during World War II.
10,000 reasons for my heart to find some blessed.
Welcome to Alrigg Church of Scotland. Of the four churches that has been seen today, this is actually the newest one. It was opened in 1913, built as a United Free Church, and then in 1929 became Church of Scotland. At that time, there was another church at the bottom of the road in Castletown, and it was the East Kirk, and this was the West Kirk. In 1938, the East Kirk closed, and this became Alrigg Church of Scotland, as it is today. We have the hall at the other side there, and it was 1960, I think it was built in, and it's quite a big, substantial hall. The manse, of course, over by was sold at the end of 2008, it would be, and obviously it hasn't got anything to do with the church now. We have a medium kind of congregation, but they are faithful attenders and good workers if you need them to do anything. The community in itself in Castletown, well, the East Kirk that I previously spoke about, only now, after several years, is owned by a couple who are going to be making it into a house. So that will be interesting because it's quite a project for them. The village itself probably has about 1,000 in population. There's a school and there's the shop, hairdressers, garages, etc., post office, but well-used butcher shop, and there's also the Free Church as well.
Yes, sir.